Hello, welcome back guys, welcome back to a brand new video of Mighty Ghost Hack YouTube channel. So guys, this video will be the continuation of Angular Performance Optimization playlist. So here today's topic is bit similar to the previous video which I uploaded earlier on YouTube channel, and today's topic is on lazy loading of component. In the video which I uploaded on lazy loading of module, so both are the different, not similar, and I recommended you guys to watch this video for performance optimization of your Angular project. And one thing, let me remind you, see, if you want lazy loading of module, or you can say single page lazy loading, then you can do it in all Angular version. There is no any dependency, but here today we will see lazy loading of component, and this is possible only after the Angular 9 version of project. So suppose you have Angular 6 or 7 project, then lazy loading of component will not help you, and all this possible after Angular 9 version, just because of IV compiler. And here we will see what it is, because today's topic on lazy loading of component. So before we move further, let me show you the main difference between lazy loading of module and lazy loading of component. So first let's see the lazy loading of module. Let me show you on this page, and let me open the inspect element and move into the network tab. After click on the JS tab button, so we will able to see only JS file request in this tab. See, when I click on sign in button, it will redirect to us into another page, and once it done, let's check the network tab again, and here you will see the page request is made on demand, and this is just an example of module lazy loading. Now let me show you on other page as well. Similarly, you can see other pages request is made on demand. So ultimately it helps us to optimize the Angular application. And if you want to know how it is going to be done, then check out the video by click on the I button. I will provide its link in the description as well. Now let's take a look at the lazy loading of component. Here you will able to see two different button, and those button will load our lazy loading component on the same page, and all those our component are loaded lazily. Let me show you. Similarly, we will look into its request on network tab. Now when I click on these two different buttons, it will load on demand. See, it's appear. Now click on another button and it's also loaded successfully. Now check on network tab. See, each page is request made on demand and server to a client on the browser. Also when the request is made for again, then it will not make any request to the server because it's already loaded on the client browser. So this will be the today's topic. We will see how we can create it. Now first and foremost, let me close all the terminals and create a new project so I can show you from the beginning. While creating a project, let me open it into the Visual Code Editor. At least it will save a little bit time, and wait now until it get finished all the installation. Now let me pause until it finish. Now it's done, our new project creation is done successfully. Now let's run it. So this is basically a home page of newly created project. Let me move into the HTML and clear it first. And before we move further, let me copy the required CSS from my existing project. Those are only required for the presentation purpose. So let me do it fastly. So far, required CSS are copied successfully. Now, let me write the HTML as well. Alright guys, HTML creation is also done successfully. Now I need to create a two component of for lazy loading example. We will create it simply by the Angular CLI command. Hope you all are familiar with the Angular CLI command. And here I am adding skip import flag, just because I don't want it going to be registered into app module file. If you know, whenever we create any component by using the ng-generate and component name, then it going to add into the app module, because it is an entry point of each component. It make its registration over there, but here we don't want that. Our purpose is to load it lazily, so we don't want it to register. So we will simply skip that. For that, here I am specifying the skip import flag. Also, I also don't require the test file, that's why adding the skip test flag as well. Now, similarly, let me create another component by using the same command, and also need to change its name. Alright, component creation is also done. Now, we have to add an event on this button, and that event will be on the click. So let me add the event on button. Also need to create a function of the TypeScript file, else we will end up with an error. So it must create the function. Alright, done. Now here we need to import two different methods from the Angular core library. Here one is the view container reference. Now you can understand the view container reference as a container where one or more view can be attached, and it contain the create component method, which will going to use to host our view into the real DOM. So view container reference is just holding another views, and it has the create component method for hosting those view on our real DOM. Now another component is component factory resolver. Well, this is just a class that we will going to use as a argument inside of view controller, inside of view container reference. Now we imported, we need to create its instance as well. Let me create it. Now we will import the first lazy component by giving its path. Here we import it as a some variable initialization. Now here it's giving us the error. For that we need to add async await, because it will take some time to load, so we need to add async await. Now let's check on the browser. After click action, it is importing or not. Same for that, we need to check on the network tab. Now let me click on this button. Now it is loaded lazily, but it is not rendered on browser real DOM. For that we need to add two line of code into our class component. So let's do that. Here inside of view container reference, we need to add create component method. Now in create component method, we will use the component resolver factory as an argument. And lastly, pass the component class name which we wanted to render. So this is it. This single line will render the component on DOM. Let's check again. See, it's loaded lazily on demand. Now let's add same features on the second button by simply copy pasting this line. Let's check. Here I am forget to pass the imported class into the factory result on method. It's done. See, both components are loaded lazily. Now let me remind you, there is some problem. See, when I click on the button, the component is loaded but it's not getting clear. See, whenever I going to click, it's append with existing and not clearing the DOM. For that we need to use the clear function that belong to the view container reference class. So let's add on the both function and check again. Alright guys, this is a small example of lazy loading of component, and it has a more impact on our project for optimization of Angular application. You might not understand, but it's important. Believe me, it will help you for your optimization of application. So guys, so far we learned how to load the complete component lazily. Now let's see how we are going to load another component lazily, but which is inside of another lazy loaded component. For that, let me create another component by using the same command. Alright, it's done. Now we will load this component on lazy loading two component. For that I need a button. So let me copy quickly. Also, let's change its name lazy1 to lazy3 and need to create function as well. And we require to inject the dependency. So let me copy the whole constructor and paste it. Need to import it as well. Now what I will do, let me copy the whole same function and paste it here. Now we need to just give its path, actual path of lazy3 component. Alright, let's check on the browser. Now click on the lazy2 button. Here lazy2 component loaded and it contain the another button, that's why it's prop here. Ignore the presentation part. You can keep this button below by using some CSS and adding some button styles here. Here I am not doing it, just simply understand the whole process. Okay, now let's try to click on lazy3 button and it's loaded the component successfully. Let's check the other button action. Here everything is work fine. Now you may understand by using those two lines of code you can load the component lazily. Now let me show you when you import component in normal way. For that let me comment out this line. And import it in normal way. Here we imported in normal way. Now check its behavior on the browser. Let's do some action. for lazy 1 and lazy 2 component are imported on demand. So both are work fine. But when I click on lazy 3 button, see, it will not loaded the component lazily because it's getting added into lazy 2 component in this lazy 2 component file. So now let me show you its lazy behavior by using the previous way. Let's check now. Let's do some action and see, all three components are loaded on demand, means all are loaded lazily. Hope you guys understand. And this video getting too long, there are some other thing needed to show, such as data passing in between lazy component and real time uses. I will cut this here and will continue in the next upcoming video. And before you leave, like, share and comment and show your support by like this video, and your single like will give me the motivation to make more videos. So guys, till then, bye.